Hey guys, welcome back to my small engine repair channel. This is just a quick follow-up to my previous video on a hidden fuel filter screen on carburetors. The reason I'm making a follow-up is because I've had a lot of questions and people have been asking me, how did you come across that little screen? Well, I came across that hidden screen by accident, and the reason I did is because when I have older carburetors, I strip them and keep certain parts. So here are some carbs here that have been scrapped or that are not going to be used on any more machines. Now, I don't always throw them out in the garbage. Sometimes I do take some of the parts off, like the connector, sometimes the butterfly shaft because the plastic breaks here. And if the bowls are good, I save those as well. And one day I was taking off a connector because I do like to keep them because sometimes they do come in handy. So I just took off the connector on the carb, looked inside, and saw a screen. And another question I've been getting in the video is, will you find a screen on Arian's carburetors? Well, this is an Arian's carburetor here, and I do not see a screen in there at all. I've mostly been seeing these screens on the MTD Powermore carburetors. Now, you might come across some other carbs with a small screen, but like I've said, so far it's only been on the MTD Powermore carburetors. Now, for the summer equipment, it is possible that you will see some on different offshore equipment as well. And let's take the connector off of a Honda lawnmower carb here, and we'll see if there's a screen. And there's absolutely no screen in this one. Hopefully you can see in there. It's just a hole. Now, you won't find a screen behind the connector here on Tecumseh carburetors like this that come off flathead engines and overhead valve engines. And I don't think you'll see some on the smaller Briggs engines like this and the bigger snow engines as well. Now, another question I've been getting a lot under the video is it necessary to have that little screen in the carburetor? Well, my answer is no. Now, if you have watched my video in its entirety, you will see that I did add an inline fuel filter like this. Now, I did leave the small screen in the carburetor, even though I added this filter. So I want to reiterate that it's not necessary to have that little screen between the connector and the carb on your equipment. There's usually like a screen in the fuel tank as well of your machine. And if you add this filter, you already have two filters. Somebody was also asking, why did you add an inline fuel filter if there was already one in the tank? Well, the simple reason to that is because, as you saw in the previous video, the small screen where the connector was in that carb was full of dirt, even though there was a screen in the fuel tank. So guys, I will emphasize that you might want to add a fuel filter in the fuel line between the carb and the tank. And I do recommend that you only use filters with screens in them. Normally, the filters with cardboard inside of them are for equipment with fuel pumps. Now, this might still work, but I have run across some of them where the fuel actually stopped flowing after a while because it was just gravity fed. So use filters with screen for gravity fed engines and filters with cardboard cartridges for engines with fuel pumps. And here's a small collection of parts here that I saved from carbs, as I showed you over here earlier. There's tons of good parts you can save, guys, if they're not corroded. I especially saved the small jets here. I think they're air jets or low idle jets. I have made a video previously showing how to enlarge that jet to stop your engine from surging. So if you do scrap carburetors, save these, take them out. They're just underneath here. You take the plastic screw and pull them out. Just save them because if ever you break your drill bit in there to enlarge it, you can just grab a spare one that you've saved. And I did mention that if you lose that little screen between the connector and the carb, you can take one from a carb kit. You can also buy these little screens individually without taking it out of a carb kit, but these little screens do work perfectly in the carb. So that's my follow-up on the video, guys, and hopefully I've answered all the questions that I missed. If I missed any more, just put them underneath this video as well. So that's how I found out about that little screen, guys, is totally by accident. It's possible that I may have even thrown out some carbs in the past because I didn't even know that little screen was there. These are things that the manufacturer and the dealers will not tell you that are there. And maybe sometimes they don't even know themselves because that little screen does not come up on the parts list if you look online for the breakdown of the parts. So I've put the link to the video I'm following up to right now. Go watch it if you haven't seen it. If you've already seen it, if you have any more comments or ideas, please post them below the video. Thanks again for watching. Make sure you're following me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and have a great day.